is the Writer's Almanac for Wednesday, the 23rd of September, 2020. It's the birthday of the jazz saxophonist John Coltrane, born Hamlet, North Carolina, 1926. Asked to describe his style, John Coltrane said, "I start in the middle of a sentence and move both directions at once." It's the birthday of Ray Charles Robinson, born Albany, Georgia, 1930, the father of soul. It's the birthday of the tragic poet Euripides, born 480 B.C. in Athens, best known for his plays Medea, the Bacchae, Iphigenia, et Aulis. Euripides was one of the first writers to portray mythical heroes as regular people, and his dialogue was less structured, less formal, closer to normal everyday speech. It was Euripides who said, "Tragedy isn't getting something or failing to get it. It's losing something you already have." It's the birthday of Victoria Claflin Woodhull, Homer, Ohio, 1838, who in 1872, even before women had the right to vote, she became the first woman to run for president of the United States on a platform of women's suffrage, nationalization of railroads, the 8-hour workday, direct taxation, abolition of the death penalty, and welfare for the poor. She was able to finance her own campaign because her very good friend Cornelius Vanderbilt had given her stock tips during the 1869 gold panic, and she netted around $700,000 from them. Victoria Woodhull, who once said, "Let women issue a declaration of independence sexually and absolutely refuse to cohabit with men until they are acknowledged as equals in everything, and the victory would be won in a single week." Here's a poem for today, a poem by George Bilgear, entitled Museum. "My father once sold a Chevy to Stan Museum, the story goes, back in the 50s, when the most coveted object in the universe of third grade was a Stan the Man baseball card. No St. Louis honky-tonk or riverfront jazz club could be more musical than those three syllables rising from the tongue of Jack Buck and the dark mouths of garages on our street where men like my father stood in their shirt-sleeved exile, cigarette in one hand, scotch in the other, radio rising and ebbing with the cards. If Jack Buck were to call my father's drinking that summer, he would have said he was swinging for the bleachers. He was on a torrid pace. In any case, the dealership was failing, the marriage a heap of ash. And knowing my father, I doubt if the story is true. Although I love to imagine that big hayseed smile flashing in the showroom, the salesmen and mechanics looking on from their nosebleed seats at the edge of history as my dark-suited dad handed the keys to the man. And for an instant, each man there knew himself a part of something suddenly immense, as when, in the old myths, a bored god dresses up like one of us and falls through a summer thunderhead to shock us from our daydream drabness with heaven's dazzle and razzmatazz." Museum, a poem by George Bilgear, used by permission of the author here on The Writer's Almanac. Funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.